Shine like the stars. Let's celebrate, 'cause it's a new day.
Spread the good vibes, make someone happy today.
The world is opening up, it's time for a ride. Let's rise to the top. Forget, leave your worries behind. Let's talk and have fun, be together as one.
Be who you are,
be who you
shine
are.
Like the stars,
we'll be here with you. Let's make the whole world happy.
Be who you are,
be who you
shine
are.
Like the stars,
shine like the stars.
We'll be here with you. We're gonna make this world dance.
We're gonna make this world dance.
Happy Thursday, B-Fam! We hope this week has been fruitful so far para sa inyo. And as we get ready for the weekend, hang out with us muna dito sa studio. I'm Bianca Gonzalez giving you a home away from home only here on BRGY. Life's surprising recipes create the most meaningful and the most flavorful journey. Diba? Hindi man natin alam kung ano yung ma-expect natin sa buhay until we embrace the different opportunities that come our way. And actually, I always say na itong napasok ko sa aking buhay ay isang happy accident din, which is why I'm so happy that this is our theme for our episode. I've mentioned this in the past episode, akala ko off-cam ang magiging career ko, yun pala on-cam. And today, I get to do both. Our guests for today have also turned their happy accidents into unexpected breakthroughs. For our first guest, she found the recipe for her success in food content creation and has lumpia wrapped her way to the hearts and tummies of her millions of followers online. Let's welcome to BRGY food content creator and lumpia queen herself, Abby Marquez. Yes! Hi, Abby!
Hello po!
Welcome to BRGY!
Hello po! Thank you for having me!
Nice to see you again!
Yes!
Please have a seat! Congratulations, of course, on the Webbies!
Thank you. On
being now a Webby Award winner.
Yes.
Major.
Congratulations. Thank you po.
That happened kasi shortly after Women's Month.
Yes.
Na-shocked ka nung nalaman mong panalo ka.
Yes po.
How does that feel na ikaw yung first Pinoy to win an award at the Webby Awards?
Yes. Pure happiness and yung pagka-proud ko ba? Kasi being the first one, I feel like I had a contribution, kumbaga, na nadala ko ang Filipino food to new heights.
So we're gonna rewind a bit to student Abby, because you actually graduated from hotel restaurant management. Mm-hmm. Pero magna cum laude. Iba din.
Ooh, na-flex ako ni Miss Bianca.
Yes. When you took up that course, ano yung like original dream?
So the original plan actually is more on the corporate side or the management side of things. Mm-hmm. Because yung course namin na ito ay anchored siya to managerial subjects, courses. Okay. And if magdi-discuss kami ng what are the potential careers you can take after mm-hmm. this course, usually it would be general manager in a hotel.
Okay.
Or an F&B manager in yeah. a restaurant.
So yun yung akala mo magiging
yes,
career
opo.
Mo.
Opo.
Mm-hmm. And then it was in your latter years of college that you started creating videos.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Ano? Because this was the height of the pandemic.
Parang Omicron era.
Hindi ko na maalala yung mga
Omicron
variants.
Era, mga 2 years na po.
Kasi when you were finishing school, that was the online school era.
Yes.
The virtual school era. So that was what spurred mm-hmm. itong content
yeah.
creation.
It allowed me po to spend more time in the kitchen and yes, ano po yun eh, online class moments ko yun. Mm-hmm. Last semester in college and we were supposed to have our practicum or yung mag-OJT ka sa labas.
Mm-hmm.
So we were really given the time to work.
Pero, I mean, even though what you're doing now is technically different na kasi it's more in the food side talaga and then media production. Mm-hmm. Ano yung, I guess, best thing na natutunan mo pa rin from your course
yeah.
na na-apply mo until now?
Nagamit ko siya very much nung first year ko as a content creator because I had to be my own manager. So, I had to wear a business hat. I spoke to brands, I had clients. Aside from actually doing the content, it really helped in that.
Aside from being a foodie, eto, I was so happy to discover na si Abby ay minsan na din palang naging vocalist sa isang band at nag-upload ng mga song covers online.
Ay, iba. Itatakal pala yun sa interview na to.
So, bago ka namin pasampulin, minawarning na kita, yes, saan nang galing yung as a singer?
So, since I was a kid, I really loved to sing. Kaya nung like, when I was in 6th grade until my whole junior high school, I attended actually summer voice lessons. Senior high school, doon na ako nag-join ng parang band.
So at this point, syempre, hindi ka namin papakawalan without hearing the voice of Abby Marquez, the singer. Is it okay if you sing a few lines for us?
Sige po.
You're hurting me. I met your girl. What a difference. You just see in her, you ain't seen in me.
Galing! Grabe, nakakatuwa. Buti hindi ka napasok sa, kasi diba, well, you started creating videos during the lockdown, technically.
Yes.
And ang uso noon, mag-live stream ng kumakanta.
Oh, yes.
Hindi mo naisip gawin yon. Mas hindi, cooking
hindi
talaga.
Naman po. Parang hindi ko rin naisip i-monetize or gamitin yung singing in like an earning thing or something na magpapasikat thing.
Personal.
Yeah, it's my personal
gets ko naman
love.
Yun.
Yeah.
We wanted to talk about your family, of course, and you are very lucky that you have a very tight, close-knit family. You were talking about the support of your parents earlier. Pero when you decided to pursue content creation full-time, hindi kasi siya pa, I mean, of the older generation, medyo may fears pa na career ba to.
Yeah.
Did your parents also have that reaction or were they supportive from the get-go?
Thankfully, yun naman, hindi ko siya na-feel because just 1 month after I started, I already got something tangible out of content creation. Hindi na siguro naging mahirap i-imagine for my parents what could be the future for this career.
Correct.
So, naging supportive naman po sila.
Correct. And you mentioned you were making all these videos nga during the lockdown. At ang naalala kong visual ng making videos at home during the lockdown is very kanya-kanya productions. Lahat.
Yeah.
Ikaw. Opa. So, I was curious, did you have that situation also na kunyari, ikaw nga kasi yung on-cam eh.
Mm-hmm.
Behind the scenes ba, it was your family, like yung tatay mo ba sa ilaw, tumutulong, or your siblings ba sa paghihiwa ng mga ingredients, may ganun ba?
Almost all of the time, it's just me.
Just you.
Yeah, so it's a one-man production team. Pumapasok na lang yung family ko for help when I really need it.
And you were surrounded by achievers. This is one thing I heard about your family, na parang lahat kayo merong medyo achiever mindset.
Yeah.
Yan, wanting to improve, wanting to learn. Your mom naman, mas discipline.
Yeah.
These are very, I guess, Pinoy values.
Ooh.
As well. Oo. Nakatulong sa'yo yung achiever mindset na yun growing up? Or was it also...
I think it both helped and ang negative na dala-dala niya ay minsan nga mapapressure ka.
Correct. Lahat naman ng lahat ng motivation, pagdi-discipline ay talagang nagbunga at nagagamit mo din ngayon, which is why you have been heralded by the online world as the Lumpia Queen. At yan ang ating i-dissect naman, ang Lumpia Queen era ni Abby. When we return here on BRGY. Welcome back to BRGY. You're still with me, Bianca Gonzalez, and we are still with the Lumpia Queen, Abby Marquez. Dahil nga Lumpia Queen si Abby, we wanted to talk about this era of your life by showing you different kinds of lumpia as well. Okay,
yes.
At yun ang ating pagkukwentuhan. So first, lumpia, complete.
Yes.
Yeah. Lumpiang Shanghai. Yes. Siyempre, lumpiang Shanghai, laging present sa lahat ng mga any occasion na meron ng mga Pinoy, di ba? Because yeah. Nakaka-happy, it has mm-hmm. a celebration feel to it.
Yeah.
I did want to know, in the first place, mahilig ka ba sa lumpia?
Mm-hmm. I don't think I really involve myself in lumpia more than an average person.
Okay.
But I really loved the concept and I loved eating in Sandaan.
Yeah. So tama ba, medyo it was a happy accident that you stumbled upon parang different lumpia recipes for content? Mm-hmm. Can you tell us mm-hmm. that story? Mm-hmm.
So I started with this marshmallow chocolate lumpia experiment dahil may leftovers ako from an outing mm-hmm. and nung nasa bahay na ako, nakita ko sila together.
Mm-hmm.
And again, an intrusive thought moment. Parang, what if iprito ko kaya yung marshmallow sa lumpia?
Of course, in the content creation world, especially on the platform you're in, ang bilis ng trends. Parang like, ito yung uso one day, the next time you check it, yeah. iba na naman. As a creator, how do you, I guess, keep up with the trends, mm-hmm. but at mm-hmm. the same time, ano pa rin, firm ka dun sa voice mo, mm-hmm. sa gusto mong gawin. Mm-hmm.
Number one, you really have to know what worked for you and what's gonna be your core. And that's what you're gonna keep for all your videos. So for me, it's quality. It's always having my videos bring value to others, either educational or entertaining.
Mm-hmm. I'm happy you said that, but we'll talk about that later in just a bit. Before that, we want to show you the next type of lumpia that we would like to talk about. And this is, of course, turon. Turon, of course, talagang sweetness, happiness, di ba? Classic merienda yan.
Yeah.
Laging hinahain kapag yes. dessert, kunyari sa isang pa-fiesta yeah. or pa-gathering.
Yeah.
With your work as a content creator, madami siyang proseso, di ba? Mm-hmm. The planning, the actual making, the yeah. post-production or the editing. Ang haba nung kailangan mo gawin just to put out one video. And
yeah.
the research that goes into it, etc. Pero ikaw, ano yung pinaka nakakapagpa-happy sa'yo?
Number one is, I already actually enjoyed the process because that's how I started. But yung pinaka naging kalaban ko dyan is, how do you keep your passion alive while also having it as a job?
Right.
So, naging maganda naman yung relationship ko with cooking because I cook even when I don't film.
Mm-hmm.
And that, yung pagluto ko ng hindi ko siya kailangan videoan, it's something that makes me think I'm keeping more of it to myself.
So, hindi pa nagkakaroon ng time, knock on wood, hindi pa yes, nagkakaroon yes. ng time na medyo nag-fizzle out yung passion mm-hmm. na yun so far? Uh-huh. Parang hindi pa.
Hindi pa. Fizzling out of passion, not yet. Not yet, uh-huh. no. But more on the, siguro yung mga creative burnout na sinasabi nila, I think that comes with the amount of things you put on your plate.
Right.
I'm trying to be careful with it. I'm yeah. trying to protect myself with that.
Yeah.
yeah.
Ang ganda. That's so important, di ba? Yung mahanap yung tamang pacing.
Pacing.
Para hindi yeah. ka maubos. Mm-hmm. Parang ganon. Okay, we have another lumpia. This is the last lumpia that we would like to show you. Yes. Oof. Ito favorite
Same.
Ko.
Same.
Oh my gosh! Yeah, as in, lumpiang toge, okay. lumpiang gulay, yung yeah. talagang ang saya. Nakaka-happy talaga. Yeah. Oo. Pero syempre, for this particular conversation, dahil toge ang laman niya, it will symbolize growth.
Wow. Kasi, glow food.
Parang growth, gano'n. No? As yes. gulay. Oh. And you talked about it earlier, isa sa mga pinaka highlights of the past few months, I guess, mm-hmm. for you, is your growth in terms of a creator because ang dami mong naka-collaborate yeah. during your trip to the US. So you went mm-hmm. to the US for the awards, pero ginawang work trip din.
Yes.
So can you tell us about those exciting collaborations mm-hmm. with mm-hmm. US-based creators?
I really just wanted to make the most of the trip. And one of the things I really wanted to do is to meet and work with people who I admire. Mm-hmm. And those are the food creators in LA, mm-hmm. in New York.
Grabe. Okay, so let's give them a rundown of the creators that you were able to meet
oh, yeah.
and collaborate with while you were in the US. So you already mentioned Uncle Roger.
Yeah, I also did... there's a lot of food creators from New York and LA, like... Flavors by Ale, Albert Can Cook, Chef Rush, QCP, a lot of Filipino creators mm-hmm. as well mm-hmm. dahil merong malaking Filipino community yes. doon, like Kidyon General, Janelle Eats, Philip Lemoyne. But the another interesting thing is yung creators not from my niche. So that's OMG Adrian. He's an amazing filmmaking niche creator. Mm-hmm. And Sawiti also.
After mo na experience lahat ng yon, ano yung common thread, biggest takeaway na nakita mo?
Lahat sila gustong matutong magluto ng Filipino food.
Oh, that's yes. so nice.
Because each time we plan a collaboration, we would think of the recipe na lulutuin namin. Yeah. And they all want to do Filipino food.
Grabe, nakakatuwa. Thank you for what you do, honestly, uh-huh. and for planting the seeds nga that will help Filipino cuisine really be more known in the world. Mm-hmm. You are so many doing it at the same time right now. Yeah. So talagang, the timing is right.
Yeah.
Grabe. To everyone who is looking into going into content creation or is into content creation right now, whether food or sa ibang bagay, mm-hmm. ano yung isang bagay na gusto mong i-advise or sabihin sa kanila?
Be proud of Filipino food because the trends that we are seeing right now and with everything that I realized and found out when I went to US is people actually want to learn more about Filipino food.
Maraming salamat, Abby Marquez, our lumpia queen. Maraming salamat. Just like Abby, di ba, nag-experiment lang siya sa iba't ibang mga lumpia recipes and na-surprise siya ng mga endless opportunities for growth and even representing the country. Yeah. Maraming salamat, Abby. We hope that conversation inspired you. Muli, maraming salamat. And we'd like to give you this chance, of course, to promote your channel or anything you'd like to share with everyone
yes.
watching.
You can watch my videos on Facebook, Abby Marquez, Abigail F. Marquez on Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. See you there.
Daming aabangan.
Yes.
Daming ginawa eh.
Ang daming ginawa.
Nakabahan ko na lahat ng mga
yeah.
content. Thanks
so,
so much, Abby. It's so nice
Thank
to
you
reconnect with you. Up next, kikilalanin naman natin ang susunod nating guest na nakahanap din ng surprising recipe sa kanyang buhay and career. BRGY will be right back.
For me, alo? Ba't ako naging emotional? For me, a simple hi, a simple kamusta, means a lot na for me, ha?
Yeah.
Hindi ko alam sa iba, pero it means a lot na for me.
Welcome back to BRGY BFAM. Our next guest smashed her way into the entertainment industry when she won Best Actress at the 2023 Cinemalaya Philippine Independent Film Festival for her debut film, Rookie. One of the breakout stars of Philippine cinema last year, we have licensed architect and former volleyball coach turned actress, Pat Tingjuy. Hi, Pat!
Hi!
Welcome to BRGY!
Hello!
Nice
Happy to
meet
be
you.
Here. Thank you.
Please,
Hi.
Take a seat. Welcome to BRGY!
I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
It's so nice to finally meet you because I've heard so many things about you.
Yeah.
Of course, To give everyone a background, the film Rookie was your first film ever.
Yeah, that's right.
And then, nanalo ka agad ng Best Actress. That's incredible.
Yeah, thank Grabe. You.
I can't believe it's been a year, but how has this past year been so far? How has your life changed since that Best Actress Award?
Like, a lot happened. Like, a lot of people just suddenly messaging me, congratulating me. Even people I haven't spoken in how many years.
Mm-hmm. Congratulations to the entire team. So, like I mentioned earlier when I introduced you, si Pat, very multi-hyphenated. So, you're an architect. Mm-hmm. You also coach volleyball for kids. And you're an actress. So you're into these different things. But one thing that I read na very interesting is you mentioned that you have moments that you still struggle with confidence. Mm-hmm. And sometimes parang may mga bouts of self-doubt. Mm-hmm. How do you deal with that in the different things that you do?
Mm-hmm. I just stop what I'm doing, like take a deep breath. And just like walk away, step out for a bit, okay. Then come back.
Yes. Actually, and we wanted to ask you that because of course, napakaraming nakaka-relate doon, di ba?
Yeah.
Whatever industry you're in, kung ano man ginagawa mo, meron talaga mga times na parang, ayaw ko ba to? And I guess you being in different industries and doing different things, do you see na parang, your background bilang architect nakatulong sa'yo bilang coach, nakatulong sa'yo bilang aktor? Parang nagko-complement ba yung iba't ibang ginagawa mo?
Actually, yeah. I got asked this question, then I'd say na, like, being an architect, I learned to be, like, very meticulous and very, like, spot on the details.
Of course, here at BRGY, we want to get to know more about our guests. And one thing we found out about you is, you really live an active lifestyle because aside from volleyball, tennis is also one of the sports that you love to play. And this time with your family, para siyang bonding activity ng pamilya. Sobrang in nung tennis right now, ha?
Yeah, nung pandemic.
But I mean, specifically itong 2024.
Really?
Yeah, parang everyone has like, it's either running club or may mga tennis something. Kasabay siya ng... paddle, yeah, yes. Paddle and pickle. Hindi lang dito sa Pilipinas, but I guess in other countries as well. So kayo, kailan ninyo naging favorite pastime, favorite bonding activity ang tennis?
Yeah, I've been playing tennis with my parents.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if they're playing with their friends, and it's not if their turn, they're gonna put us on the side. And my dad would just teach us how to play.
Pero nakakatawa nga because it's something you love doing with your family, even if medyo iba-iba kayo ng field eh. So, your mom is a dentist, your dad is a consultant sa tech company naman. Your siblings, what are they into?
Well, my sister's also a dentist, mm-hmm. my kuya's an engineer, and my little brother is graduating accountancy.
So, no one is in media at all.
I guess that's me na.
Yeah, so ikaw na ang representative. So, how did that land on your lap?
I've been wanting to do that. I just don't know how to do it.
Okay.
So I just had a friend who's a producer and she just told me, oh, audition ka dyan.
Ang galing. At so tapos, best actress agad. Iba talaga. Of course, volleyball, we've been talking about it and you mentioned that you have three siblings. You are the third.
Yeah.
Is that correct? With three siblings. And one of your siblings played volleyball also before.
Yeah, he did.
Who is that?
That's my kuya. Like, he's the one who really introduced me to sport.
And then, when did you, I guess, get to enjoy it na parang you wanted to play it more, you wanted to devote more time?
I can still kind of remember it. I was just sitting by our front door and my brother was just doing like ball handling. When he took a break, I asked him, Kuya, turuan mo ko niyan? Anong ginagawa mo?
There is another side to Pat because bukod nga sa pinag-usapan na natin, you also have an entrepreneurial side because you have a cake business. Is this correct?
I mean, it's not yet a business.
You're working on it to launch
kind
it?
Kind of. It's still like very blurry, like what I want to do with it.
Of the different things you're doing, ito, isa na namang bagong bagay. When did you think of starting your own business? At bakit cake business yung naisip mo?
My sister and I would sell cookies and cupcakes back in
high school.
Okay.
So I guess that's how it like started.
When did the idea of actually, you know, restarting it and making it a business mm-hmm. start?
Well, it really started nung pandemic. I made a cake for my mom. And from there, the people in our house that time, they're like, ang ganda, ang galing. Then I told my sister, what if magbenta tayo ng cake?
Grabe, no? And of course, sa dami ng iba't ibang bagay na nasubukan mo so far in your career, for you at this point, saan pinaka-sweet yung success?
But I guess the sweetest success would be having won the award of Best Actress.
Mm-hmm. This nga has opened many, many more opportunities for you. And we have heard that one of the other things na gusto mo din i-try is singing. This is the first time actually also learned yeah. that it is also an interest of yours. Can we hear you sing a few lines of your favorite song? Na on the spot si Pat bigla.
Ang lamig ah.
Malamig po dito sa studio talaga. Oo, sige. Warm up lang ng konti. Oo.
Something told me it was so over.
In fairness, I felt your thank kaba. You. Pero lamig. Mas lalo lumamig sa studio. Oo, oo. I'm sorry, I don't know that song. Can you tell me what the title is and who the artist is?
So it's I'd Rather Go Blind by Ita James.
If ever you get the chance to perform or when you're invited to sing, is it something you're open to?
Yeah, I guess I am. Mm-mm, that would be an experience.
Yeah.
Another new thing on my list.
I know. Actually, our whole conversation was about trying new things, embracing like little opportunities that come your way. To anyone who's listening to this, who also has those opportunities, those doors opening, pero napapangunahan ng takot, ng fear, I guess what's something you'd like to share with all of them?
Trust yourself, trust your talents and your knowledge. And just keep moving forward.
I love that. Maraming salamat, thank you, Pat, thank you. For joining us and for sharing your story here on BRGY. Is there anything that you'd like to promote or anyone you'd like to say hi to anywhere around the world? Go ahead. This time is yours.
I'd like to say hi to my family, my mom and dad, my sister, brothers. And yeah, please do follow me on Instagram at Patinghuy.
Yes, on social media accounts. Yes, aabangan natin kung ano yung mga susunod na gagawin ni Pat. Siyempre, tulad ng naging kwento ni Pat, diba? Parang when you try new things, hindi naman talaga mawawala yung mga kaba, mga true. Self-doubt, mga fear, diba? Kaya ba natin to? What will other people say? But like she said nga, diba? If you don't move, if you don't do anything, you won't move also. Nothing's gonna happen. So muli, maraming salamat,
thank
Pat.
You,
thank you so much
thank
for
you,
joining
thank you so
us.
Much.
Sana naka-inspire ang aming conversation sa inyo, BFAM, and that is why at this point, we would like to show our love to all of you. Through our BRGY shoutouts, hello to Rachel Sanilel from Dubai, to Lindia Teodosio from Canada, and to Heidi Rodriguez Viray from the US. Hello sa inyong lahat! Let's discover more surprising and exciting stories from our BRGY guests by watching our past episodes. Of course, pwede nyo rin kaming mahanap sa iWantTFC app, and in case you don't have it yet, download the iWantTFC app via Google Play or the App Store, or pwede nyo rin bisitahin ang iwanttfc.com, and you can watch this show and all your other favorite Kapamilya shows. We also invite you to subscribe to our TFC Facebook page and all our social media accounts for exclusive BRGY content and of course updates sa lahat ng pinakamalaking events brought to you by the Filipino Channel. Muli, Pat, maraming salamat.
Thank you, Bianca.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, BFAM.
This has been Bianca Gonzalez giving you a home away from home only here on BRGY. The world is